Aldo.
It's a part of giving information to the public.
Counter coming
which
in from
Derek. Which they can decimate and understand. I think the voters in India are very smart. They can understand what is right or wrong. They
Devesh
don't
Thakur.
Need an election commission interference.
Devesh Thakur, very interesting. Nowadays, whenever the BJP speaks, the first counter comes from the JDU.
I'd like to add one more thing.
JDU.
Well, it's
like
a freedom of expression for the JDU.
JDU counter to you.
Yes.
JDU counter. Aryaman, after the JDU, please. I always like to pair the BJP and the JDU on these issues.
One more thing.
Once I like to get the JDU in after the BJP and the BJP after the JDU. Yes, Devesh Thakur. At least on this, do you agree with the BJP or are you disagreeing with them on this as well?
No, I think we have never been inconsistent as far as the ban on opinion polls are concerned. Our leaders have always maintained that these opinion polls, and let me remind you, right from the last 10 years, 8 years that we have been in power, and are with the friends of the BJP with us, we have always said that we are not in favor of any opinion polls. Exit polls are okay, but opinion polls we have not been in favor. We do feel they have a tendency to influence the neutral voter maybe, or the voters of the state and the country, and we are in favor of a ban on that. We have not been inconsistent as far as our stand.
But then what about newspapers, news channels, panel discussions, articles, blogs?
Ban everything.
Then you'll have to stop even campaigning, because in campaigning I may take a particular stand which will influence the voters. And in any case, opinion polls have margin of error and they have to keep the methodology.
What's who's countering, Congress or JDU?
And it's not a BJP versus Congress debate. It is the Election Commission of India which has sought opinion of everybody. Let the Bharatiya Janata Party go and give all these arguments. And they are saying that the Election Commission has no such right. May I take up the argument of Mr. Sundaram and only say this much. Free and fair election is part of the basic structure of this constitution. And the Election Commission, having been vested with a right to conduct and duty to conduct fair elections, can impose reasonable restriction. What is that reasonable restriction can be discussed by Election Commission
what?
Of India.
Oh, so you
what? 92 specifications.
Serial debate happening here.
Counter from Shazia, please. Shazia's counter, then Naresh Gujral. Sorry to come to you last, Naresh Gujral. Yes.
Now. Yes, Mr. Gujral, with your permission, sir. What entails, respectful or restrictions? One wonders about that. Where would you draw the line? Would you ban opinions? Would you ban the agenda setting function of the newsrooms? Would you ban all government spending? Would you ban all mention of Food Security Act and Aadhaar? Would you mention the usage of the scheme of Sardar Patel statue?
Yeah, what all will you ban? I fear today you're not letting Naresh Gujral speak because his position is not agreed.
No, that's nothing of that.
You seek my indulgence. I'll come to you after Naresh. I've decided to come to you after Naresh. Allow me. Now, the argument and rationale given here is that these polls can influence voters. First of all, the government says in 2005 it cannot influence voters. In 2013 it says it can influence voters. Now let us assume a scenario, Naresh Gujral, where a newspaper or a news channel breaks a huge news story that goes against the incumbent government. Let's say it does that, right? Will that also influence voters? And because it influences voters, should all, exposes or news channel coverage that can influence voters also be banned before an election? I mean, what all will you ban?
Arnab, a blanket ban is not only totally undemocratic, but is not called for. And I can understand why the Congress party is so discomforted today, because the way the wind is blowing, every single opinion poll that comes shows that they are losing ground rapidly. So I understand their position. But having said that, it is also a fact that the quality and authenticity of opinion polls is sometimes suspect. And I have no hesitation in accepting on the national television that almost every political party has used unfair means sometimes to influence opinion polls.
Mr. Naresh Gujral, first of all, the counter to that is very simple. The counter to that is if a channel gets an opinion poll wrong, it will affect the channel. So first, it should not be any of your concern, right? It's between the channel and those two it's broadcast to. The question here is, are they really that bad? I want to share some statistics, Randeep Surjewala, then counter me, and then Derek O'Brien too, who thinks that opinion polls are bad. I want to give. By the way, I don't know, but I told 2011, West Bengal projection showed 184 to 192 was the range of one of the pollsters. Vote percentage was 39%. There was 0% deviation, with 184 seats as the actual result and the vote share being 39%. If that's not accurate, I don't know what is. But that's not only West Bengal in 2011. You'll find it interesting that surveys and exit polls in India, let's bust a myth, have had a very respectable success rate when compared to surveys around the globe, Mr. Surjewala. More than 125 assembly and parliamentary elections have happened in India in the last 20 years, right? Of these elections, only 7 or 8 times the polls have picked up a totally wrong number, like 2004 Lok Sabha, 2007 Tamil Nadu, 2012 Punjab. Okay, even among these, not everyone got it wrong, barring the 2004 Lok Sabha elections where everyone predicted NDA is getting more votes. If you look at the projections history of the top 8 polling institutions operating in India, Mr. Surjewala, 95% surveys and exit polls have picked up the trends correctly and projected the correct winner. You understand? But more often than not, everyone picks up the small number of wrong projections to discuss rather than the huge number of accurate polls in India, which happens to be officially the most heterogeneous and difficult society to conduct polls in. So cut some slack, Mr. Surjewala. When you get your numbers right, you also ask about the number of times. Did you complain when people said the Congress party would be winning in different states? You didn't. Let's hear your count.
Arnab, please have, now that you've given figures, please have the patience to have two figures. In 2004, your polls reflected NDA 270 to 282.
I've already mentioned
NDA
that.
181. UPA was given 167, UPA got 218, 50% wrong. In 2009, NDA was predicted to get 195, it got 159. UPA was projected to get 201, it got 262.
No, you have read out what I have said.
In 2012,
you are repeating what you have said.
Congress victory in Punjab. What you are, came in, what,
you see,
protest,
is this a debate about accuracy of polls or about banning
the BSP,
polls?
The Samajwadi Party got romped in.
Mr. Sudhir,
geography, topography, sample size, scientific nature of
totally.
The fragmentation
totally.
Amongst voters, the number of political parties in fray.
Mr. Surjewala,
people will make their own call. They don't have to go by opinion polls.
Influence voters in some manner or the other.
No, people don't go by opinion polls. I'm sure the electorate in India is wise. When even in 77 they chose to remove the Congress, or in 80 to bring it back, Indian electorate votes very sensibly, even though they did not have all the polls at that time.
Similarly,
it's possible the polls may have influenced them.
And
they may have thought that we don't want the victory that the polls are showing. So it's possible that there was an impact of the polls.
Atul Kumar Ranjan wants to come in. By the way, I want to say this before we get Mr. Ranjan in. The present survey, the representative sample, okay, which assembly segments, how you weigh this according to the census profile, mention of the margin of error at the state level and at the regional level, along with tracking studies of public opinion, along with the total number of the cumulative sample size of number of interviews over the last 6 months, every single part of the data is acceptable. Mr. Surjewala, if despite all of this, the number is not palatable to you, the result of the survey, the question will be asked to you, are you complaining more about the result than about the process? Atul Kumar Ranjan wanted to counter you there. Atul Kumar Ranjan, please, to the Congress.
No, in a democracy, the political parties have a right to speak. In a democracy, the media, the electronic media, print media, the fourth pillar of Indian democracy has a right to judge the things. All right. But the questioning is, through banning the media, banning the opinion poll, banning the exit poll, I think In a democracy, in a vibrant democracy, it is not up
but
to
But why is this happening?
When the more and more, more young people want transparency. More and more.
But why is this happening?
That yes, the media has also to... No. Just a minute, Arnab. The media has also to play a very positive role and very responsible role.
But the...
And there are unscrupulous elements also. That has to be taken into care. And I think there should be an authority should be made. If something went wrong, they can watch the thing.
But this is the problem. Western interests also take place. Mr. Anjan, don't mind
play
it.
Their role.
Don't and mind it. But in 2009, when we predicted a Mamata victory... When we predicted a Mamata victory, many left leaders said you are on the payrolls of Mamata. Right, in the last 2011 and in 2006 when people predicted the left victory.
This is all wrong.
Please understand one. Everybody is pleased. You know, they said the truth will be out on the day of the results and all opinion polls will be proven wrong. This is a fact, Mr. Atul Kumar Anjan. The truth is unpalatable. But the inconvenient truth, Mr. Anjan, is always the better truth. At least I think so. Should we open up to callers?
Don't you think there are folks inside the media, those who play dirty roles, those who play dirty games. For them, there should be a balanced mechanism within the media structure. There should be some authority to check such type of thing. You cannot play such a vast majority of the democracy in a fashion what you like.
Derek O'Brien, there are two counters, Derek O'Brien first, then Ariman Sundaram, and then callers.
Me also.
One second.
I will.
Derek O'Brien.
I'm not countering today. I'm listening very patiently. There are just three quick points. First is, as far as the Trinamool Congress goes, three quick points. One, we believe that the people are smart enough, the housewife is smart enough to make her own decision. Number two, the final call on this, we believe, will be taken by the Election Commission. Whatever is their call, we will respect it. And number three, there are good opinion polls, there are bad opinion polls. Like in 1948,
have
you heard of somebody called Thomas Dewey? No one's heard of Thomas Dewey, but every opinion poll in the United States said Thomas Dewey was becoming the president. Harry Truman became the president. So I think it's a very nice extracurricular activity. You enjoy the extracurricular activity.
I'll tell you this. You know, first of all, let's not trivialize what is a fairly detailed pursuit because I can't let this go unrebutted. Kerala 2011. I'll send the figures to Derek O'Brien. First of all, Derek O'Brien must know Assam 2011, West Bengal 2011, Pondicherry 2011, Tamil Nadu 2011. Kerala 2011, Uttarakhand 2001, Derek, don't lose patience. Uttar Pradesh 2012, Manipur 2012, Goa 2012, Punjab 2012, Gujarat 2012. If I look at the vote share, Himachal 2012, Andhra Pradesh by-election 2012. If I look at the vote share accuracy, it's over 98%. You can look at this, and by the way, this is not some extracurricular activity.
Great.
Right? That's all.
Let's bust that myth that it is some extracurricular activity. Yes, listen to me.
And I agree with you. This debate about accuracy of opinion polls or about freedom of speech, you make up your mind. Everybody is talking about accuracy or inaccuracy. The issue is freedom of speech and expression is absolutely, you cannot compromise on that.
Freedom
of speech is at a higher pedestal than any other freedom. And the only restriction that can be put on that
counters.
Is under Article 19.2,
which
is sovereignty of India, integrity of India,
Piyush Goyal, not the kind of excuses that is being given by the other panels. Piyush Goyal, we are getting counters, Ariman Sundaram, then we are opening up to calls. Yes, please. Callers, please, in a minute.
Arnab, I think it's absolutely shocking what I've been hearing. We are really, after me, please. I think it is absolutely shocking what I'm hearing. What I'm really hearing is there is a chance that there are some bad opinions, there are chances that there are some good opinion polls. Therefore, since there's a chance of a bad opinion poll, let us stop opinion polls altogether. In other words, there's a chance
no,
of some
no,
people
we are not
misusing
saying
freedom of speech.
We are not saying
there's
that.
A chance that
Who said we're saying that?
Right. Now, in case...
We're not
one
saying
minute,
that.
Let me finish. Let me finish. So, in case...
Please.
In case some people misuse it, let's get rid of freedom of speech. What are we talking about?
No,
if somebody misuses it, there is a
no,
mechanism by
that.
Which they will be punished for it. But nobody
oh,
can
Lord.
Say, look at the bad opinion polls, ergo,
Absolutely.
You have to stop
yes.
opinion polls, and therefore you must curb the expression.
Or no, we are not asking
no, no, one
you
second.
To stop opinion
ridiculous.
Polls.
One
Absolutely
second, there are, as of now, I would
we
say...
We are not asking you to stop opinion
no,
polls.
No, 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 my point...
Let me finish, Arnob. No, let...
Okay,
we are
Derek.
Not asking you, listen Arnob, let the panelists, let the panelists
I
counter the panelists. You
sir,
want to counter every panelist and conduct the debate.
Okay, counter, please, go ahead.
Listen, it's not countering. I agree with what the gentleman is saying. Who on earth is telling you that Trinamool is asking you to ban opinion polls?